All right, kids, due to the coronavirus, people may be in quarantine, isolating themselves, or practicing social distancing.
They better be.
One thing that we all have in common is we're probably watching more TV. As of me recording this, we're going on 2 full weeks without sports, which is most of what I usually watch. And with the Tiger King making me question what world I currently live in and who else lives in it, I found myself looking for TV shows from the past. I searched through the 2010s, the 2000s, and the 90s, and one show just hit a little different. For some weird reason you didn't know, that was from the TV show Martin. The thing with Martin and me is that I was a kid when that show aired. I was just in the 8th grade when it ended, but man, no other TV show has captured my imagination like Martin. In the first episode of this channel, I referenced this player from the Himalayas, Jerome, before showing this clip. Martin represents the 90s so well, but it doesn't get the same kind of love as Seinfeld, Friends, or even the Fresh Prince for that matter. It's hard to find. It's not like it's on Nick at Night. It kinda has a cult following in that there's no such thing as a casual fan. When you get into it, you really get into it. Like owning exotic animals. Not even my wife understands why I call generic burger joints hoochie burger, and she can tell you that when we get a dog, I'm gonna name it Dragonfly Jones, but she doesn't get it. More than 20 years after its finale, Martin still has an influence on the culture. People celebrated the 25th anniversary of its debut. LeBron James created a Martin-inspired shoe. He also dressed as Jerome for Halloween. Big Sean made a music video in Martin's image. Kanye and Chance the Rapper dedicated parts of verses to the show. And Martin is still quoted all the time. So this is me showing my appreciation for Martin and all of his comedy, complexity, and controversy. On August 27th, 1992, the pilot episode of Martin aired on Fox. It starred comedian Martin Lawrence as Martin Payne, a radio DJ who lived with his girlfriend Gina, played by Tisha Campbell. Co-starring was Tashina Arnold as Gina's best friend Pam, and Martin's best friends Tommy and Cole were played by Tommy Ford and Carl Anthony Payne II, respectively. Most episodes centered around these 5 characters, but with the exception of supporting roles and recurring characters, it seemed like Martin Lawrence played everybody else. The show followed Martin as he was simply trying to make it. During the show's run, which ended too soon, and we'll get to that later, Martin went from hosting a radio show to being unemployed and doing odd jobs and temporary work to hosting a local talk show to his show being picked up on network in the end. Along the way, Martin and Gina were together, then broke up, then got engaged, then married. If the main storyline didn't keep you interested, then other things would, like why was Pam's breath so bad? What does Big Shirley look like? What does Tommy do for a living? Running gags that I look forward to were fights with Miss Jerry, fights with that chinchilla rat-coon thing, and well, Martin didn't really fight with Angry Man, so I just looked forward to hearing his catchphrase.
Man, sit your ass down.
I have a 2-way tie for my favorite episodes from Martin, and they actually aired back-to-back from the second season. In the first one, Martin gets a traffic ticket for running a stop sign and goes to court in order to defend himself, knowing that he's wrong. Martin falsely accused the cop of racial discrimination, got the draws, hilarity ensues. In the second one, Martin's Walkman comes up missing and he accuses everybody of stealing it. He has everybody wear black and he confronts everyone about it Nino Brown style in a New Jack City kind of way. And these episodes remind me, Martin lived the overarching black experience. That included what each character said and how they said it, what they wore and how they wore it. I mean, Martin lived in an apartment building in Detroit and had bouts with crime, racial discrimination, and poverty. The call letters for the radio station he worked for were WZUP. His talk show was called Word on the Street. The show incorporated rap and R&B, evidenced by hip-hop culture references and guest appearances and cameos from Biggie Smalls, Method Man, and Jodeci, just to name a few. But in watching the show as an adult as opposed to when I was a kid, some aspects of the show wouldn't hold up today. A number of patterns didn't age well. I can picture a Martin is over hashtag for his male chauvinistic views, hypersexualized black man trope, stereotypes, LGBT phobia, and making fun of a dark-skinned woman while exalting his light-skinned girlfriend. To give the show credit though, Martin's problematic views sometimes blew up in his face and taught him a valuable lesson. Sometimes when I tell people that my favorite TV show was Martin, there's a pause, and then they say, oh, Martin Lawrence's show. I don't think people remember how much of a star Martin Lawrence was. He was the man. Now, maybe some of that is a generational gap or a black culture or racial gap, sure, but with the exception of Bad Boys, which had mass appeal, all of the things I'm about to name could just be known to black people stuff. Martin had smaller roles in Do the Right Thing and House Party. He was the first host of Def Comedy Jam because he was a great stand-up comedian in his own right. He was once seen as the next Richard Pryor and Eddie Murphy. Martin Lawrence would go on to star in movies like Nothing to Lose, Life, Blue Streak, and Big Mama's House. He even hosted Saturday Night Live once, but his monologue did a little bit too much. On reruns of that episode, SNL doesn't even include that footage. Plus, Martin was banned from ever being on the show again. This incident didn't involve the law, but it served as a precursor to Martin's legal troubles, which ultimately led to the show's end after only 5 seasons. Even with that, the 5th season was kind of incomplete due to the lawsuit from co-star Tisha Campbell, who alleged that Martin Lawrence and producers from the show sexually harassed her on and off the set. Tisha Campbell didn't appear in several episodes during that final season, and when she did, after the lawsuit was settled out of court, her and Martin Lawrence were to never be seen on set at the same time. Scripts and storylines from the show involve Martin and Gina coming and going at different times. An example of that is in the episodes Going Overboard Parts 1 and 2, where Gina missed a cruise ship, therefore she wasn't in either episode. Recently, the cast of Martin made up and reunited. Sadly, part of that involved the death of Tommy a few years ago, but the legacy of all these characters lives on. Earlier, I mentioned that there are people who don't know who Martin is or know what the show was. Still, there are others who are readily able to recall details about the show in order to debate several topics. Who would you rather be with, Gina or Pam? Who's your favorite character played by Martin Lawrence? Answers to that question can prove to reveal a lot about your personality. I even debated myself about which Martin theme song I should use in this episode, the one I played earlier or this one. I couldn't tell you which one is better. The big question is, which is better, Martin or the Fresh Prince of Bel Air? You can tell what my answer is. Since Martin ended, and the Fresh Prince for that matter, a lot of black sitcoms have come and gone, but none have had the same impact with me as Martin. I had a lot of hope in the Carmichael show, and Blackish is a game changer and the most noteworthy, but it's been difficult to find something that provides me with nostalgia like Martin. It's sad because I feel like I have no one to reminisce with. But that's part of the reason why I'm making this episode, in order to show my appreciation for what was. To this day, there can't be many higher compliments that I can pay my wife than to tell her that she's so almondy. And if I needed to kick somebody up out my place, I would tell them to get to stepping. But we're self-distancing, so I don't need to. I can chill and watch Martin and be reminded of a simpler time when I didn't know there was a Tiger King. So we gonna be alright.